早晨 everyone, my name is Martin Wong and I am a photographer. Today, I want to offer some tips for people who are getting into photography or just want to get better at photography in general. Especially with Black Friday just passed and Christmas is coming up, I'm sure some of you are getting a new camera this holiday season. I have been doing photography for over 15 years, give or take, and I've been editing for over 20 years. So hopefully I got some useful knowledge that I can share with you. So here are 11 tips that I have jam-packed in 5 minutes. All right, let's start the clock. Number one, don't focus so much on deciding which camera you should get, especially if it's your first camera. You might not even know what you need. Getting expensive camera is not gonna guarantee you good photos. Number two, I'm sure most people next question is, what lens should I get? My suggestion is figure out what you wanna shoot first. If you don't know the answer to that, I wouldn't be able to give you a good recommendation. Everyone has a different idea of which lens is the best. So don't just ask one person's opinions. For example, if you ask me, shooting landscape, I'll use this guy. A wide angle 1435mm. And if you're shooting portraits, I will use this guy. A 105mm prime telephoto lens. Number three, in digital photography, both photo taking and photo editing are equally important. To me, they are yin and yang, and I use one to do the job that the other couldn't. For example, it is a lot safer to Photoshop fire effects on a model than lighting them on fire. But it is a lot easier to shoot during the daytime than it is to Photoshop a nighttime photo into a daytime photo. Number four, you don't always have to shoot in manual mode. And in fact, I don't. Shooting in manual doesn't mean you're a better photographer. The manual setting does give you more control over each aspect of the photo taking process, but it doesn't mean it's the best mode to use for every single situation. However, with that said, you should learn how to shoot in manual, so when you need it, you'll be ready for it. Number five, understand the difference between doing photography as a hobby or as a profession. Just like many art forms, like painting or dancing or singing, your approach to photography would be very different if you're doing it to make money instead of just doing it for fun. Even streamers approach video games very differently if they're doing streaming as their full-time job. As a professional photographer, you need to understand how you're adding values to your customers. I also just did another video on how much you should charge for your work, so you should go check that out. Number six, learn how to challenge your creativity by giving yourself some restrictions. Oftentimes, we lose focus because we have so many options. You can practice getting better creatively by forcing yourself doing projects that use specific color, a specific environment, or a specific lens. So like for example, back in college, I trained myself by seeing the world with the lens that I'm holding at that very moment. So let's say I'm holding a 14mm lens, I'm gonna see the world at a much wider angle. And if I'm walking around with a 200mm lens, I'm gonna be looking very far away for very close-up details. There's no such thing as a perfect lens. Your wide angle is never gonna be wide enough for that shot you need, or your telephoto lens is not ever gonna be long enough. So you have to learn to use what you got. And the more you do this, the better you'll get, because you're gonna be more certain about what you need and what you get. Speaking of creativity, here's number seven. Imitation is not a bad thing. When you're imitating others, not only you're learning a way to create photo, you might also discover a new style that you didn't know you liked before. You might also find out how much you hate that style, and then it'll lead you to discover other styles. It's kind of like taking an intro class in college. You might find out that you love a subject, or you realize you hate it so much you want to change your major completely. Not like biochem. Oh my god, biochem. That's a nightmare. Ugh. Number eight, don't buy a camera just cause someone said it's great. There's always gonna be some fanboys who love a specific camera just cause they can recite some marketing booklet. And then they're gonna tell you like some specific feature that's a great, like it's very high megapixel, very high ISO, or great in-body camera stabilizations, or whatever it is. But half the time, they don't even know what the heck they're talking about. I would highly suggest you do your own research and figure out what you want because it's what you need. And most of the time, you're gonna find some camera with the same or better features for even a lower price. So do your own research. Number nine, work backward. When you're buying gear, you need to know how to work backward. Meaning you should find out what you want to create and figure out what is the final result that you want. Then work backward to find out what exactly the type of gear that you need to accomplish that. Don't just buy some random equipment just because you think it's gonna make your photos better. Don't do that. In fact, I made a whole video telling you how not to buy gear. So you should go check that out too. Number 10, move. Move a lot. move left, move right, move up, move down, just move around because it will literally give you a whole new perspective on your subject. Find different ways to explore the angles. That's how you're gonna get better shots than other people who are shooting the exact same things. Last but not least, number 11, don't stop improving. It is very easy to fall into the trap of being comfortable. Social media has made it so much easier for you to have a false sense of accomplishment. You're getting likes, you're getting comments, all those amazing engagements. But you know what? You should not let that stop you from getting better. If anything, it should be the complete opposite. It should serve as a reminder telling yourself, you got to where you are right now because you work hard for it. So you need to keep working harder and harder to go further and further. All right, that's it. Those are the 11 tips that I can offer you today. Let me know which one is your favorite in the comment section down below. And give me some suggestions for future videos. And as always, find more of my latest content on my other social media platform, my Twitter, my Instagram, my Facebook, and you can chat with me on my Discord. And that's it. I'm out. Oh my God, that's gonna get into bloopers, isn't it? Some of you are getting a Christmas. Black Friday does. Sorry. Black Friday, I'm sorry. So you can go check that out creatively. Creatively, 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 creatively. Putting in the legwork? Who say that? Do I say that?